This tutorial is part of our practical database design course. You can find a link to the YouTube playlist for this course in the video description. Alternatively, if you like this course, you can watch the complete course uninterrupted, ad-free, access updated tutorials and download the source code and more from our Udemy course. Again, the link to the course is in the video description. In this tutorial, we're going to try and define the normalization process and how it can be applied to the relational database design process. This is going to be important to learn because in this course, we design a relational database using a set of standards from the traditionally taught normalization process. So to better understand our design process, like I said, in this tutorial, we're going to introduce the classically taught normalization process. So broadly speaking, and in the context of relational databases, I would describe normalization as a process that is classically taught to new students learning relational databases. But simply put, let's think of it as a process of organizing data in a database. Breaking this down a little bit, the normalization process includes a set of so-called normal forms. We try to arrange our database, organize our database based on the rules or standards defined at each normal form. So the general process, our data starts in an unnormalized form. At this stage, we have identified the preliminary entities and attributes. We then work through the normalization process, first arranging our entities and attribute tables and fields into first normal form. We then move into second normal form using the rules and standards of a second normal form and so on. So we don't have to follow this process step by step. We can sometimes very quickly arrange our fields and tables into third normal form. Now, your table and fields can only be in third normal form or second normal form, etc., if they meet the standards of that particular normal form and all the other standards and rules below that. So if I want to get my tables into third normal form, I need to make sure that they are meeting the standards or rules of the third normal form, second and first normal form. So typically, we aim to develop our database design into at least the third normal form. We might refer to this as the operational level. Now, for various reasons related to performance trade-offs, it is not always considered beneficial to normalize further. In this course, we aim to get our database design into third normal form. So we work through the normalization process in order to reduce redundant data, repeating data that might be within our database tables. The normalization process also encourages us to think about how our attributes and fields relate to each other, so dependencies, and steers us towards having only related data in a table. Ultimately, this all leads to helping to protect the integrity of the data that we store in our database. Once you understand the normalization process, you will quickly spot potential redundancy and dependency issues within the table. One of the recommendations that I make is that when you're trying to find redundancy and dependency issues, that you try and model your data in a table, and that will give you a better view of your data and identifying these potential issues. Taking a look at this table here, there are a few different occurrences here of redundant data. So for example, here in the student name, we have potential repeating names. Now, these are both the same student. Now, of course, students will have similar names, but it looks like this student is the same student. So we're repeating this student's information twice, so we have redundant data. If we have a look at the subject fee, for example, we can see that the subject fee, database 2 subject, the data here, the subject fee, is being copied twice. So we have some more redundant data. So ideally, we're trying to remove that and only specify the subject fee once for, in this case, a particular subject. Of course, we're repeating the subject fee, so potentially we are repeating information about the actual subject. Now, let's imagine we wanted to, for example, update this subject, database 2, the amount it costs. In our database, we might have multiple occurrences of this. So if we were to update this subject fee to maybe 600, we would have to do that for every single field of that instance. And that's where potential errors? That's where potential errors occur. And then last of all, you can see there are some redundancy issues here that looks like we're repeating information about the student as we previously saw. So the normalization process is going to allow us to remove some of those, or at least reduce the amount of redundant data. Now, dependency is a little bit harder to explain, and we will move through this in this course, and I will give you a better understanding of dependency. But here what we have is the subject fee. How can we determine how much the subject costs? Well, we do that by first of identifying, for example, the subject ID. So if I were to know the subject ID, then I can then determine from this table, from this row, the subject fee. So we can see that database 2, anytime there's a database 2, you can see that the numbers are the same. So we can say that the subject fee is dependent upon the subject ID. Now, one of our goals to move into the third normal form is to make sure that all the attributes here will be associated or dependent upon what will be known as the primary key. And in this instance, that's not going to be true potentially. So there's something that we need to do to remove this from this table. And by doing that, not only are we going to remove and resolve the dependency issue, but we will also reduce the amount of redundant data in this table. And we'll see that later on once we start to talk about dependencies and establishing relationships between tables. Our first task, our first target in our database design process is moving our preliminary entities and attributes into first normal form. Although this might be difficult to understand now, I'll break down the process into two processes. We will learn these steps in the following tutorials and then apply this process to the preliminary entities and attributes we have generated from our project requirement. So the first normal form, each attribute needs to contain only one value. So for our data to be in first normal form, we need to make sure that each attribute contains only one value and that all attribute values are atomic. So that's our goal, that's our target. And like I said, I'll break this down. We'll move through this step by step and we'll work towards this goal. So to summarize, the normalization process is a process of organizing data in our database. Typically, we're looking to build or meet the standards of the first, second, and third normal form. So the goal of normalization process is to reduce the redundancy, duplicate data in our database, and to organize the attributes in our related tables further, reducing redundancy. As a result of this process, we will have eliminated anomalies when performing everyday actions, inserting data, updating data, and deleting data in our database. Now, of course, this all leads and feeds into the overarching aim of keeping our data safe and error-free. Like I previously mentioned, in this course, we will work towards designing our database to meet the standards specified in the first, second, and third normal form.